Hello friends, welcome to eKida. Title of the lecture is Medium Transmission Line. So in our last video, we have already studied about the medium transmission line for end condenser method. Now in this video, we'll study about the nominal T method and nominal phi method. So nominal T method, this method is also known as middle condenser method. Basically, nominal T method and nominal phi method are mostly used methods. So in this method, whole capacitance is assumed to be concentrated at the middle point of the line, and half the line resistance and reactance are lumped on its either side. Means they are equally divided. Resistance and reactance. So, capacitance is assumed to be concentrated at the middle point of the line, and this resistance and reactance are lumped on its either side, means equally divided. Now, the arrangement for nominal T method. So, the equivalent circuit for nominal T method R, L, R, L, and capacitor is assumed to be concentrated at the middle point of the line. This is the sending end voltage, sending end. This is sending end current IS. This is receiving end. So receiving end voltage VR, receiving end current IR, this is capacitance, voltage across the capacitor, VC, current, IC, charging current or capacitor current, and resistance and reactance are lumped on its either side, means they are equally divided. So R by 2, L by 2 or JXL by 2, same R by 2, JXL by 2. So this impedance Z by 2, and assume load, lagging load, this is load, so load, lagging load, phi R, and this IR receiving current is flows through this load. So total resistive drop in this circuit, this I is R by 2 plus IR I by 2. Total resistive drop is equals to IS R by 2 plus this IR R by 2 and total reactive drop, this is equals to J IS XL by 2 plus J IR XL by 2. And the total impedance drop in this circuit, total impedance drop, this is equals to IS into Z by 2 plus IR into Z by 2. So see in this circuit that this sending end current, this IS is equals to IC plus IR. This IS sending end current is equals to the charging current or the capacitor current plus the receiving end current. So this IS is equals to IC plus IR. Now see, capacitor is not close to source as well as it is not close to load. So VC, the capacitor current, is not equal to VR as well as it is not equal to VS. So apply KVL at the input loop as well as at the output loop. So for the input loop, VC is equals to VS plus IS into R by 2 plus J IS into XL by 2. Now apply KVL to this input loop and as well as to the output loop. So while applying KVL to input loop, so this is equals to minus VS plus IS into R by 2 plus IS into J XL by 2 plus VC, this is equals to 0. IS into R by 2 plus J IS XL by 2 plus VC, this is equals to 0. Or we can write this equation as VS, this is equals to VC plus IS into R by 2 plus J IS XL by 2. Now apply KVL to the output loop. So minus VC plus IR into R by 2 plus J IR into XL by 2 plus VR, this is equals to 0. VC minus VC plus IR into R by 2 plus J IR into XL by 2 plus VR, this is equals to 0. Or we can write this equation as VC, this is equals to VR plus IR into R by 2 plus J into IR XL by 2. Now we'll draw the phasor diagram, and please remember that phasor diagram should be drawn from the output side. So this is the equation for the output side. So take VR as reference for the phasor diagram. So this is the VR as reference. Now we assume that load is lagging load. So this IR is lagging, and the angle between them is phi R. Now VC is equals to VR plus IR into R by 2. So this is in phase with IR, IR into R by 2, IR into R by 2 plus J IR XL by 2. This J IR XL by 2, 90 degree from the IR into R by 2. This is IR into XL by 2. Now the phasor sum of this VR plus IR into R by 2 plus J IR into XL by 2, this is equals to VC. So this is the sum. This is VC. And this IR into R by 2 plus J into IR into XL by 2, this is equals to IR into Z by 2. So this is equals to IR into Z by 2, because this R by 2 plus XL by 2 is the impedance Z by 2. See this diagram. This R by 2 plus J XL by 2, this is the Z by 2. So the sum of IR into R by 2 plus J IR XL by 2, this is equals to Z by IR into Z by 2. Now capacitor current lead capacitor voltage by 90 degree. So this is the capacitor voltage, and capacitor current leads it by 90 degree. So this is the capacitor current, and see this equation, IS is equals to IC plus IR. So IS is sending in current, is the sum of capacitor current plus the receiving end current. So we'll move IC parallelly. So this is IC. and the sum of IC plus IR, this is equals to IS. So this is equals to IS. Now we have to draw this sending end voltage. So this VS is equals to VC, VC in phasor, VC plus IS into R by 2. So this IS is in phase with IS into R by 2 is in phase with IS. So this is IS. So here this is IS into R by 2. Wait. This is IS into R by 2. Now 90 degree IS into XL by 2. 90 degree. J into IS into XL by 2 and the sum of VC plus IS into R by 2 plus IS into XL by 2, this is equals to VS. So this is equals to VS and the angle between VS and IS, this is phi S. Angle between sending in voltage and sending in current, this is equals to phi S. Similarly, the angle between VR and IR is QR. The angle between VS and IS is phi S. And the angle between VS and VR, this is lambda. So this is a phasor diagram for medium transmission line of T model. And in this, like the sum of IR into R by 2 plus IR, J, IR, XL by 2 is IR, Z by 2. Like similarly, the sum of IS into R by 2 plus J, IS into XL by 2. So this is equals to IS into Z by 2. Now we'll find out the ABCD parameter of T model. ABCD parameter. Of T model. So this network is made up of three parts. Part 1 R L, part 2 capacitor, and part 3 again R and L. Means R by 2 and L by 2. So this is section number 1, section number 2 and section number 3. It is categorized into 3 parts. 1, 2 and 3. So see in this, this is the impedance Z by 2. Same here, impedance Z by 2. So this network is made up of 3 parts. Part 1, R by 2, L by 2. Part 2, capacitor C. And part 3, R by 2 or L by 2. So for first part, for first section, this is Z by 2, impedance Z by 2, and this is open circuit, so no shunt impedance. That's why here Z is equals to infinity and admittance Y is equals to 0. Now in section number 2, the impedance part is absent, so the impedance Z is equals to 0 and admittance is Y. And in third section, same, the section 1 and section 3 are same, and in section 1 and section 3 shunt branch is missing, and in second section series is missing. So this is also open circuit. So here Z is equals to infinity and Y is equals to 0. Because in section 1 and section 3, shunt branch is missing, and in section 2, series branch is missing. So ABCD parameter of first network or first section for first section, this is equals to, see, this is a L network and we have already calculated the ABCD parameter for L network in N condenser method. See, for N condenser method, we have already calculated the ABCD parameter see 1 plus ZY, Z, Y and 1. This is the ABCD parameter for L section. So, this is the L section. See, this is the L section. So, for L section, ABCD parameters are 1 plus ZY, Z, Y and 1. Z, Y and 1. So, no need to calculate this again. Now, for first section. So, now for first section, this 1 plus ZY. So, here for in first section, Y is equals to 0. So, this is equals to for first parameter ABCD. For first section, so this is 1. Now, in second, Z is equal to Z by 2. So, this is Z by 2. Now, Y is equals to 0. So, this is 0 and this is 1. Now, ABCD parameter for second section. So, for second section, Z is 0. So, this is equals to 1. Z is 0. So, this is 0. Y is equals to Y and this is 1. And for third section, first and third sections are same. 1, Z by 2, 0 and 1. So, these are the ABCD parameters. So, first and third section is identical. That's why ABCD parameter for first and third section is identical. 1, Z by 2, 0, 1. And for second section, as Z is equals to 0, as series impedance is missing, so Z is 0. So, on putting the value, Z is equals to 0 in the L section. So, this is 1, 0, Y and 1. 1, 0, Y and 1. So, let's solve this matrix. So, this is 2 cross 2, 2 cross 2. And this is also 2 cross 2. So, first we'll solve for section 1 and section 2. So, I hope you know this. This into this. So, 1 into 1 plus Z by 2 into Y. So, this is equals to 1 into 1 plus ZY into 2. Same. 1 into 0 plus Z by 2 into 1. So, Z by 2 into 1. Now, 0 into 1, 0 and 1 into Y. Y. Now 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1. And this is 1 into Z by 2, 0 and 1. Now same. Multiply this 2 cross 2 matrix. So this 1 plus Z by 2 into 1. So 1 plus Z by 2 into 1 plus Z by 2 into 0. So this is 0. Now 1 plus Z y by 2 into Z by 2 plus Z by 2 into 1. Now, this into this. So, y into 1, y plus 1 into 0, 0. Next, y into Z by 2, y Z by 2 plus 1 into 1. So, this is the ABCD parameter where A is equals to 1 plus ZY by 2. B is equals to, let's simplify this, 1 plus ZY by 2 into Z by 2 plus Z by 2. So, take Z common. So, this is equals to 1 plus ZY by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So, this is equals to Z 1 by 2 plus ZY by 4 plus 1 by 2. And this is equals to Z 1 plus ZY by 4. This is the B parameter. Then C is equals to Y and D is equals to YZ by 2 plus 1. YZ by 2 plus 1. So, overall ABCD parameter of T model. This is equals to 1 plus ZY by 2 B is equals to Z1 plus ZY by 4. 1 plus ZY by 4. C is Y and D is 1 plus ZY by 2. Please don't be confused in this Z and 2. This is Z and this is 2. This is Z. Z and this is 2. Now see, in this parameter A is equals to D. This is symmetrical. Now AD minus BC, this is equals to AD means 1 plus ZY by 2 whole square minus ZY into 1 plus ZY by 4. So this is equals to, let's simplify this, A square plus B square plus 2AB. 1 A square plus B square Z square Y square upon 4 plus 2 ZY by 2, so this 2 cancel out, minus ZY minus Z square Y square by 4. So this Z square Y square by 4, this cancel out, and this plus ZY minus ZY cancel out. So this AD minus BC, this is equals to 1. So this shows it is a reciprocal network and as well as it is a symmetrical network, because this AD is symmetrical. So T model is symmetrical network as well as reciprocal network. Now after T model, we'll calculate the ABCD parameter for pi model. Third method of medium transmission line, nominal pi method. See, in this nominal pi method, capacitance of each conductor, is divided into two halves. See, that's why it is known as pi method, because the equivalent circuit, the shape of this network is pi. In this method, capacitive effect of transmission line is represented by two capacitors, one C at the sending end and another at the receiving end, and the magnitude of both the capacitor is same. See the diagram, equivalent circuit. This is C by 2 and C by 2. This is the sending end. So this is sending end voltage plus minus, and this is receiving end. So this is receiving end current VR. This is sending end current and this is sending end current. So this is VR is a receiving end voltage. So the voltage across the sending end is VS plus minus and current IS, and this is the receiving end. So voltage across the receiving end VR and current I R. This is R, this is L, this is C by 2, this is C by 2. So current across the capacitor C by 2, this is the sending end current ICS, and this is the receiving end current ICR, and this is impedance R plus JXL. So the shape is like pi network. See, this is pi, that's why it is known as pi model. So basic relation from this equivalent circuit, CIS, this is equals to ICS plus this is the transmission line current, this is IL. So ICS plus IL, and IL is divided again into ICR plus IR. So apply KVL. So while applying KVL, see this minus VS plus IL into R plus IL into JXL plus VR. This is equals to 0. Minus VS plus IL into R plus IL into JXL plus VR. This is equals to 0. Or we can write this equation as VS equals to VR plus IL into R J into IL into XL. Now we'll draw the phasor diagram for this condition. So phasor diagram, take VR as reference and this is reference VR. So first assume load. So this is load. And assume cos phi R lagging load. This is lagging load. Cos phi R lagging power factor load. So take VR as reference. So VR is reference. So current is lagging IR by angle phi R. So now see this VR. This VR is the voltage of this capacitor C by 2. And current flowing through this capacitor C by 2 is ICR. Means load current is ICR. Now, this ICR current will lead capacitor voltage VR. So, this ICR current will lead capacitor voltage VR. So, this is ICR. Now we know this transmission line current, this is equals to ICR plus IR. So we have to move this ICR parallelly. This is ICR. And the sum of ICR plus IR, this is equals to transmission line current IL. So this is IL. This is CR. Now see this equation. Now we have to add phasor, means this VS is equals to VR plus ILR. So VS is the source and condenser voltage and VS is across C by 2. See this, VS is across this capacitor C by 2 and current ICS is flowing through this capacitor C by 2. And current ICS flowing through this C by 2. So ICS will lead VS. Now we have to add phasor. This VS is equals to VR plus ILR. So this is IL, line transmission line current. So in same phase, this is VR. So in same phase, IL into R. This is IL into R plus J ILXL. So 90 degree. This is ILXL, JILXL, and the phasor sum of VR plus ILR plus JILXL, this is equals to VS. This is 90 degree. Now, this VS is the source and condenser voltage, and this VS, see, this VS is across this capacitor C by 2 and the current of this capacitor C by 2 is ICS. So this ICS will lead VS voltage. So ICS will lead VS. This is ICR. Now this ICS will lead VS. So this is ICS, and we know ICS plus IL, this ICS plus IL, this is equals to IS, sending in current. So we'll move ICS, and this ICS plus IL, this is equals to IS. See this equation, this ICS plus IL, this is equals to IS. So we have to move this ICS parallelly. So this is ICS I'll draw this with red color so that you can understand this. This is ICS. So we have to move this parallelly. So this is ICS, and the sum of this IL and ICS, this is equals to sending end current IS. See this ICS plus IL, this is equals to IS. So this is equals to IS. So I hope you understand this concept, is that this ICS will lead this VS by 90 degree. This ICS current will lead this sending end voltage by 90 degree, because see this diagram, because this VS is the voltage of this capacitor C by 2, and the current of this capacitor C by 2 is ICS. That's why this ICS will lead this VS so by 90 degree. So I'll draw this ICS which lead VS by 90 degree, and we have to add the IL plus ICS, because the sum of IS is equals to ICS plus IL. That's why we move parallelly this ICS across the IL, and the sum of IL plus ICS, this is equals to IS. Now ABCD parameter of pi model. So same, again we break this into three parts. The model of the pi model, we break this into three parts. First part is capacitor, second R and JXL, and the third part is again capacitor. So first part is capacitor, second part is RL, and third part is capacitor again. So for first part, this is C by 2 and the series impedance is 0, so this is Z is equals to 0. In second part, this is R plus JXL, this is impedance Z, and here shunt admittance is absent. So this is Z is equals to infinity and Y is equals to 0. And in the third part, this impedance, Z impedance is 0 because series impedance is absent, and this is equals to C by 2. So ABCD parameter for L section, you know 1 plus, please learn this ABCD parameter for L section, it will help you out. So 1 plus ZY, this is B is Z, C is Y, and this is 1. And don't be confused in Z and 2. So this is ABCD parameter for L section. Now we'll calculate the ABCD parameter for first section, second section, and third section. So for first section, ABCD parameter, this is equals to C for first section, Z is equals to 0. So A is 1 plus 0 into Y, means it is 1. Z is 0, Y and 1. This is ABCD for first section. Now ABCD for second section, here Y is 0, so it is 1, Z 0, 1. Because Y is 0, so this is 0, this is 0, 1, Z 0, 1. And first and third section is identical, so same 1, 0, Y and 1. See, for first section, this Z is equals to impedance, Z is equals to 1 upon J omega C by 2, because this is C by 2. Or we can write it as admittance, this Y is equals to 2 upon J omega C. Now let's solve this matrix of 2 cross 2, 2 cross 2, 2 cross 2. So this ABCD ABCD, so this is equals to this cross this. So 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0, then 1 into Z plus 0 into 1. So this is Z. Now Y into 1 plus 1 into 0. So this is Y. Y into Z means YZ plus 1 into 1. So this is 1. 1, 0, Y, 1. same. Row into column. So this is equals to 1 into 1 plus z into y, then 1 into 0, 0 plus z into 1, z, y into 1, y, and plus yz plus 1 into y, and then y into 0, 0, and yz plus 1 into 1, 1. Now we can write this as 1 plus zy, this is z, y plus y, 1 plus zy, and this is 1 plus zy. So this is the overall ABCD parameter for pi network. Now see, A is equals to D means this is symmetrical network. So AD minus BC. So this into minus AB. This is ABCD. So A into D, 1 plus ZY whole square minus B into C minus ZY minus ZY 1 plus ZY. So on solving this, A square plus B square plus 2AB minus ZY minus ZY minus Z square Y square. So this cancel out, and this minus ZY means minus 2ZY. So this cancel out. So AD minus BC, this is equals to 1, means this is a reciprocal network. So this is a reciprocal network as well as a symmetrical network. Like, this is the calculation for the pi method, like we did for the T method. So T method is also a symmetrical network as well as a reciprocal network. That's why we have mostly used T method and pi method. So this is a very simple method. We draw the equivalent circuit for T model. Then we divide this T model into three sections. First section is R by 2, L by 2. Second section is C, and third section is R by 2 and L by 2, and we calculate the parameters, ABCD parameters. And from the equivalent circuit, we draw the phasor diagram for a particular condition. And we have taken VR as reference because we assume that load is a lagging load. Similarly, for the pi network, we divide the pi network into three parts. First part is C by 2, second part is R and L, and third part is C by 2. So similarly, for a particular condition, we draw a phasor diagram. Again, here we assume that load is a lagging load, power factor. So we take VR as reference and calculate the ABCD parameters by taking three parts. So these are the ABCD parameters, and we see that this is a symmetrical as well as a reciprocal network. Thank you.